Jerry Jeff Walker.
Thank you all. Texas has had a long tradition of female singer-songwriters, and tonight we've got Austin's newest favorite sweetheart. Let's have a big welcome for Kelly Willis.
Thank you. I'm going to do a song that our drummer, Moss Palermo, wrote. This is called Too Much to Ask.
Been made up now for a long, long time. Can't understand why you're acting so
Called Hidden Things. Thank you. you.
Thank you very much. I guess the first thing is the big voice and a little girl sure comes out. Where'd the music start for you?
Well, I sort of grew up in a musical family. My mother was an actress and did a lot of musical plays. We had a piano and she played it a lot. And so there was music in the house, I guess. But
What kind of tunes?
Mostly just show tunes. And
show
that sort
tunes,
of thing.
Sing it out.
Yeah. I didn't do anything with music for a long time until I was 16 and got an opportunity to be in a band. And that's when I had never stepped on stage before or anything, even though my mother was, doing all that stuff. But that sort of gave me my basis, I guess.
But you sang, so somebody must have known you could sing to have to invite you to be in the band.
Well, it's funny, actually. My audition tape was, I went down to the beach and, those little booths where you can go into the little booth and sing the song. I sang Teddy Bear, this Elvis song, and gave it to the guys. It was my rockabilly band. And they were like, oh, okay. It's really the silliest tape I've ever heard.
Life was simple then, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, let's remember the good times. So anyway, they said, come on, sing. So you worked up some rockabilly tunes?
Mm-hmm, yeah. I was really, really influenced a lot by a lot of those early 50s kind of rock, like the Everly Brothers and Buddy Holly. And I listened to the oldie stations when, I was in high school and stuff, instead of the top 40 or whatever. And, I was mostly influenced by people like Wanda Jackson and
Yeah, there's a Patsy certain Clark. Side of your voice that seems to really stretch for a bigger range than most songs are kind of limited to smaller ranges.
Well, I think I kind of go for the, they had an aggressiveness about them, women back then, they didn't fall into a role that they thought women were supposed to be. They sort of were real assertive and aggressive. And I think people like Patsy Cline and Wanda Jackson especially were very much one of the people in the band, a musician sort of, and sort of tried to be treated that way. And I think I really admired that and tried to emulate that even. Most of the things I write come out of, something that's going on in my life or just something that I can't get out of my head that I'm thinking about.
Well, we wish you the best of luck and keep on singing.
Well, thanks very much.
Thank you.
Appreciate it.
Still the one, no matter what you is your...
This is another new song we're gonna do for you. I wrote this summer with a guy named John Leventhal. It's called Shadows of Love.
One, two, three, four. I'm starting to get weak in the knee. I'm starting to think they're all left me. Can't you hear them whispering our names? Or did you hear them say that I'm to blame? My seems to be in doubt. I'm starting to go hell for a
everyone.
Did you enjoy Kelly?
She's wonderful.
Okay, thanks. Hope you enjoyed Kelly Willis. We had a great time. We'll see you next week on the Texas Connection.
Accommodations provided by the Wyndham Hotel at South Park.